हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, होप ऑल आर फाइन एंड हेल्थी। माई सेल्फ कोकिला भाटिया, टीचिंग मैथ्स फर्स्ट स्टैंडर्ड 7th इन सेठ विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज, वेलकम यू ऑल।
टुडे लेट अस लर्न एंड डिस्कस लेसन नंबर 10, बैंक्स एंड सिंपल इंटरेस्ट। बैंक। A bank is a government recognized institution that carries out transactions of money. Banks make it easier to plan the use of money, that is to do financial planning. We can either deposit cash money in a bank or withdraw cash from it. For that purpose, we must open an account in a bank. Now, let's know different types of accounts, children. Current account. A current account is mainly for traders and those dealing in money on a daily basis. An account holder can deposit or withdraw money any number of times in a day. The bank does not pay any interest on the money in this type of account. The bank also issues a passbook for this account and also a checkbook on demand. Now, savings account. A person can deposit a minimum amount and open a savings account. The bank pays some interest on the basis of the daily credit balance in the account. For this account too, the bank issues a passbook and on demand a checkbook. But there are some restrictions on how often money can be withdrawn from this account. Now, what is recurring deposit account, children? Now, here the account holder can decide the amount to be deposited every month in the account. The bank gives an interest on the deposit which is more than that paid for the savings account. Now, fixed deposit. Now, here children, a depositor deposits a certain amount for a fixed period in the bank. This deposit attracts a greater rate of interest than the savings account. These rates are different in different banks, but senior citizens get slightly greater rate of interest than the usual. ATM, credit and debit cards. Now children, this though you must have heard. ATM. What is the full form of ATM? Automatic teller machine. Yes. So, an ATM card is used to withdraw cash without going to a bank. A credit card or debit card is used to carry out transactions without using cash. An account holder can get such a card on request to the bank. Passbook. Now, passbook is issued for a savings account and recurring deposit account. Amounts that we have deposited, withdrawn, and the balance are recorded in it with their dates. Let's go with practice set 40, the first sum. If Rihanna deposits 1500 rupees in the school fund at 9% per annum for 2 years, what is the total amount she will get? Now, your children, Rihanna deposited how many rupees? 1500. So that is your principal at the rate of 9% per annum, and for how many years? Yes, 2 years. So your principal year is rupees 1500, your time is 2 years, and your rate of interest is 9%. And what have you to find out? You have to find out the amount. So to find out the amount, first you are going to find out the interest. So what is the formula for interest? I is equal to P into R into T upon 100, that is principal into rate of interest into time upon 100. Now you are going to substitute the value of P, R and T to find out I, that is interest. So I is equal to 1500 into 9 into 2 upon 100. So after cancellation, I is equal to 15 into 9 into 2, which is equal to rupees 270. Now you have found out the interest. So what is your interest? Your interest is rupees 270. Now, as you have found out the interest, that is rupees 270, now you can find out the amount. So the formula for amount is A is equal to P plus I, that is principal plus interest. So what was your principal? Your principal was 1500 plus, and what is the interest? 270. So 1500 plus 270 is rupees 1770. So she will get rupees 1770. Now the second sum. Jethalal took a housing loan of 2,50,000 rupees from a bank at 10% per annum for 5 years. What is the yearly interest he must pay and the total amount he returns to the bank? Now here your principal is rupees 2,50,000 and your rate of interest is 10% per annum, and for your time is 5 years. And what have you to find out? Here you are going to find out the interest as well as amount. So interest, the formula for interest is I is equal to P into R into T upon 100. Now you will substitute the values. So interest is equal to 2,50,000 into 10 into 1. Then you will cancel it. So you will get rupees 25,000. Now we have found the interest for 1 year, that was rupees 25,000, and we have to find out the interest for 5 years. So interest for 5 years is 5 into 25,000, which is equal to 1,25,000 rupees. Now we have found out the interest of 5 years. Now you have to find out the amount. So amount is equal to P plus I. So what is your P? Your P is 2,50,000 plus I is 1,25,000. So when you add, you will get 3,75,000. So he must pay rupees 25,000 as yearly interest, and the total amount he returns is rupees 3,75,000. The third sum. Shrikant deposit 85,000 rupees for 2.5 years at 7% per annum in a savings bank account. What is the total interest he received at the end of the period? Now here your principal is rupees 85,000. Your rate is 7% per annum and your time is 2.5 years. So this is written as mixed fraction. So convert it into a fraction, that is 2 2s are 4 plus 1, 5 upon 2 years. And you have to find out what? You are going to find out only the interest. So the formula for interest is I is equal to P into R into T upon 100. Now substitute the values. So I is equal to 85,000 into 7 into 5 upon 2 upon 100. So after cancellation, I is equal to 425 into 7 into 5. Now after multiplication, I is equal to rupees 14,875. So the total interest received is rupees 14,875. The fourth sum. At a certain rate of interest, the interest after 4 years on 5,000 rupees principal is 1,200 rupees. What would be the interest on 15,000 rupees at the same rate of interest for the same period? Now here children, the time is given as 4 years. Principal is given as 5,000, and here they have given you the interest. Interest is 1,200. So what have you to find out? You are going to find out the rate of interest. So you'll write the formula, I is equal to P into R into T upon 100. Now here I is given to you. I is what? 1,200 is equal to 5,000 into R into 4 upon 100. So 1,200 is equal to, after cancellation, you will get 50 into R into 4. Now this 50 into 4, when it goes to your left hand side, it gets converted into division. So R is equal to 1,200 upon 50 into 4. So after cancellation, what is the rate of interest? The rate of interest is 6%. Now after finding the rate of interest, that is 6%, what have they asked you in the question? What would be the interest on 15,000 rupees? That means now here on rupees 15,000, that will become your principal. So here your principal is 15,000 at the same rate. Same rate means that the rate that you have found out, that is 6%. of interest for the same period. Same period is 4 years. So now your P is your 15,000, your rate is 6%, time is 4 years. And what have you to find out? You are going to find out interest. So the formula for interest is I is equal to P into R into T upon 100. Now you are going to substitute the values. So I is equal to 15,000 into 6 into 4 upon 100. So after cancellation, I is equal to 150 into 6 into 4, which is equal to rupees 3600. So the interest on rupees 15,000 will be rupees 3600. Now the fifth sum, that is the last sum of this practice set. If Pankaj deposits 1,50,000 rupees in a bank at 10% per annum for 2 years, what is the total amount he will get from the bank? Now here Pankaj deposits 1,50,000. So 1,50,000 is your principal and your rate of interest is 10% and the time is 2 years. And what have you to find out? You are going to find out the amount. So to find out the amount, first you have to find out the interest. So I is equal to P into R into T upon 100. Therefore I is equal to 1,50,000 into 10 into 2 upon 100. So after cancellation, I is equal to 1500 into 10 into 2, which is equal to rupees 30,000. So your interest is rupees 30,000. Now you are going to find out the amount. So amount is equal to P plus I. So P is 1,50,000 plus I you have found out as 30,000. So A is equal to 1,50,000 plus 30,000, which is equal to 1,80,000. So the total amount is rupees 1,80,000. With this, I have completed practice set 40. Hope children you have understood. Now I'll continue with this chapter in my next session. Thank you and God bless.